So we can utilize these things to be able to affect key operators and dynamic individuals who may charismatically, politically, or through other means of power be able to affect groups. It's a ripple effect. It is a ripple effect. Moreover, we can induce a number of neuromicrobiological agents to then incur something called high morbidity. These are not necessarily mortal agents. We can modify the existing palette of bacteria and viruses through the use of gene editing techniques, very viable. This has been some of my ongoing work with my colleague Diane DeEulis at National Defense University. And what we can also do is recognize that there are existing microbiologicals that can be harnessed to then induce the effects. We can also engage certain chemicals that way. What we want here is a morbidity factor, not necessarily a mortality factor. I want to make people sick. And what I do here is the virus is not necessarily the bug. The virus is what I put over the internet. Let me show you how I can crash a system pretty easily. I affect key individuals here, here, and here. And then I take another community in the back of the room. I affect key individuals there. And then I take another community. I affect key individuals there. And then I do what every good attributional group does. I beat my chest and take credit for it. And what I put out over the internet is, this is a virus, a bacteria, an agent that I have infiltrated into your fill in the blank. I say it's a weapon of mass destruction. And what I tell you it's going to do is it's going to produce paranoia, anxiety, and sleeplessness. What I've just done is I've recruited every paranoid hypochondriac to think that they have whatever that is. I've used salient and sentinel cases, and I create essentially a legion of what's known as the worried well. They now flood emergency rooms. They flood their clinicians. The CDC responds back and says, no, 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 there is no such a thing. And I've created a schism of trust between the population and the polis. It's both a short and a long Moore's effect. Moreover, I can create particular neuromicrobiologicals that may have a much longer duration of action. For example, modified Zika virus. And what I can then do is, as a consequence of that, is I can affect subsequent generations to incur a public health morbidity and mortality effect that then creates an increased economic and perhaps social burden. Long war scenario.